The design vision for Tottenham Court Road Station was to create a station which was going to reflect the character of the area that it was set in within central London, particularly for the Western Ticket Hall, which is situated in Soho, and the Eastern Ticket Hall, which is situated in St Giles, in central London. We wanted to differentiate them by colour and also by materiality. And that was really done as a wayfinding device for passengers that were using the station. What we wanted to use was the regular grid of the streets within Soho that had been here for hundreds of years to reflect some of the architectural elements within the station. And in the Western Ticket Hall in particular, it's the structural ceiling as well as some of the manifestation that we've used throughout the station. So people experience the station by entering the new Western Ticket Hall off Dean Street. Now in the day, it'll be very well lit. We clad the ticket hall using glazing. We were very keen to make that visual connection between the ticket hall and the surrounding streets. What we wanted to do was for the ticket hall to reflect some of the nocturnal venues within Soho, the theatres, the clubs and the bars. And so the interior of the station is actually clad in black stone and glass. We wanted it to reflect some of the venues that you'll be entering as you depart the station within Soho. I think when people visit the platforms for their first time, they'll be amazed at their scale and their size. A typical London Underground platform is 100 metres long and 3 metres deep, whereas here our platforms are almost 250 metres long and 4.5 metres deep. These are very light and airy, very well lit, and they have some very good wayfinding devices in terms of graphics that will help you sort of like navigate your way through these large platform areas. So when we were designing the station, we used the line-wide components primarily within the platforms, cross passages and the ticket halls, primarily within the graphics and the wayfinding, because we allow people, especially in those stations which are key interchanges, to differentiate between the London Underground network and the Elizabeth Line network. So the light drums were, for us, a real opportunity to solve an engineering requirement. So each station needs to have acoustic absorption. And what we wanted to do was design a fitting that could not only absorb the sound, but also provide light. But we wanted to create quite a theatrical effect, almost mimicking some of the venues that people will be visiting when they visit Soho. And so what we did was we created a light fitting that was set within the soffit of the ceilings, quite organically, almost mimicking the movement of people. And this also meant that we didn't need to create a suspended ceiling, which for maintenance purposes is always a real challenge. The materials that we used in the station were specified because they needed to be very hard wearing and robust. We used concrete, glass, steel, and also glass reinforced GRC, which is a cement board, which we've used on the platforms and within the Goslet Yard. But each of these materials have to be designed to be able to be maintained for the lifespan of the project. So we believe that by using colour and materials, that is a much easier way of navigating very large subterranean spaces than purely relying on signage and wayfinding. And I think we were just mindful that, particularly in Tottenham Court Road Station, it's probably visited by the greatest number of visitors to the city than almost any other station. And a lot of those people may struggle to actually read English. And so what we wanted to use was devices like colour and art as a tool for people to move through the station. Tottenham Court Road has two new pieces of public realm located at Dean Street and at Charing Cross Road and the junction of Oxford Street and Tottenham Court Road. These are going to be critical spaces that are designed to serve the station with the volume of passengers using Tottenham Court Road Station. And so these will become key public realm hubs within the city that allow people to meet and then move on through St Giles and Soho. The oversight development designed at Tottenham Court Road Station and Dean Street were designed as integral parts of the station. At Dean Street, we're integrating retail at the ground floor, and above we're actually creating over 90 new homes. And these are homes that are located above the ticket hall as well as above a ventilation shaft. The design of the architecture for the oversight development particularly in Block D at the rear, actually mimics some of the Georgian architecture that exists within Soho. Over at Tottenham Court Road Station, St Giles, the oversight development there is a mixture of commercial offices, as well as a new theatre and new restaurants at ground floor. So these are all integrated with operational buildings that exist below. I think the benefits and the opportunities of working on a project of this scale is the people that you meet, the other architects, the engineers, the contractors, and also the skills that you learn to be able to actually put into future projects. I think some of the biggest challenges really are the number of stakeholders that you have to engage with to actually get the station both designed, accepted, and actually built. And that's both been a challenge, but also a real sort of joy. I'm particularly interested in seeing how people engage with the different elements that we use in the station, the color of the station, the light drums, and how they interface with those elements, and how they react to maybe how it will help them move through the station, and maybe it will make them stop and pause within the station and look at some of the elements that we've used, and maybe ask the question in terms of, well, why do we use them? And what story does it tell? And hopefully at Tottenham Court Road Station, you have the architects telling a story about what happens on the streets above.